बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। वेलकम टू अल मुनीर हाई स्कूल ई लर्निंग सिस्टम क्लास 7। दिस इज़ योर साइंस लेक्चर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस आवर यूनिट नंबर 8, चेंज इन मैटर। दिस इज़ द टाइटल पेज ऑफ योर साइंस बुक फॉर क्लास 7। टॉपिक इज चेंज इन मैटर। रस्टिंग ऑफ आयरन इज अ केमिकल चेंज। Physical change. When an ice cube melts, it is easy to make the water freeze again. You can get the salt back from a salt solution by drawing out the solution. Melting and dissolving are examples of physical change. In a physical change, only the behavior of the particles change. The actual particles are the same throughout, and the total mass of the substance remains the same. Ice turns to water at 0 degree centigrade. It is easy to change the water back to ice again by cooling it. No new chemical substance is formed in this change. When no new chemical substance is formed, a change is called a physical change. What is chemical change? When iron rusts or a candle burns, new chemical compounds are made. It may be impossible to reverse the process. These types of changes are called chemical change or chemical reactions. In a chemical reaction, the following things happen. A new substance is made, energy is either given out or taken in. The change is almost impossible to reverse, although the atoms of each element combine in different ways. The same atoms that were present at the start are there at the end of the reaction. Because of this, the total mass of the substances remains the same. Some yellow sulfur powder and iron filings are mixed together. The mixture can easily be separated by stirring it with a magnet. The iron filings will stick to the magnet. When heated, the mixture will glow brightly. The yellow peaks of sulfur disappear. A black solid is formed. The black solid is not at all like the mixture. It is not affected by a magnet as shown in this figure. Here we have some chemical and physical changes. The black solid is obviously a new chemical substance. The iron and sulfur have reacted together to form a compound, iron sulfide. The above chemical change can be written in a word equation and in the form of the symbols as shown in this. What is reversible reactions? There are some reactions which can be reversed. A simple example is the physical change. When ice is heated to form water, the water can be changed back into ice. Another reversible reaction or change is the heating of blue copper sulfate. It decomposes to give white copper sulfate powder and water vapors. What is reversible reaction? If water is added to the white copper sulfate, the reaction is reversed and blue copper sulfate is reformed. This is called a reversible reaction. The symbol for this is this. Another example of a reversible reaction is when ammonia gas and hydrogen chloride gas come into contact with each other. A white cloud of ammonium chloride vapor is formed. Changing raw materials into useful products. Fertilizers, plants need water from the soil. They also need different elements. The three elements they need most are nitrogen, potassium, and phosphorus. Plants use up these more quickly than other elements in the soil. Small amounts return to the soil in animal manure, and when dead animals and plants decay, some nitrogen is also put back by lightning and by bacteria in the soil, but not enough. Soon the soil is too poor for new crops, so the farmer must replace the missing elements by adding fertilizers. Fertilizers are chemicals like these: ammonium nitrate, ammonium sulfate, ammonium phosphate, calcium nitrate, potassium sulfate, sodium nitrate, and urea. Ammonium nitrate is a useful fertilizer. It is a salt which contains nitrogen, an element essential for plant growth. A good fertilizer contains the elements needed to promote healthy growth in plants. It must also be cheap to produce and soluble in water. In industry, ammonium nitrate is made by reacting ammonia with nitric acid. Harmful effects of the improper use of chemical fertilizers. Long-term use of chemical fertilizers can be harmful to soils. They can lead to a breakdown of soil crumbs and an accumulation of organic acids in soils. When a soil's crumb structure is destroyed, it becomes a fine powder which is easily blown away by the wind and washed away by water, causing soil erosion. Excess fertilizers sprayed onto fields are washed into rivers and lakes where they cause algae to grow fast. The algae spread over the surface, blocking out light of the plants below. Plastics, many objects that used to be made of metal are now made of plastic. A plastic is a synthetic material which can easily be shaped. Plastics are usually tough and versatile. They are very good electrical insulators. They can be spun into fibers to make clothes and carpets, or molded to make objects such as cups or chairs. Plastics are polymers. Polymers contain very large molecules that are made by adding together many small molecules called monomers. Some familiar polymers are polyethylene, polystyrene, and polyvinyl chloride, PVC, nylon, perspex, and trillin are the common names of some other important plastics. Polyethylene is made from the monomer ethane. Long chains of about 50,000 ethene molecules added together are formed. What do the numbers of fertilizers mean? Nitrogen grows up plants, phosphorus reaches down to the roots and helps produce blooms, and potassium promotes all around well-being of a plant. Nylon is a plastic that can be made into thin fibers which can be woven into cloth. Here we have the list of some plastics and their uses. Fossil fuels. Hundreds of millions of years ago, while ancient forests were starting to form coal on the land, other fossil fuels were being made under the sea. We use them now as oil and natural gas. Oil was made from the microscopic plants and animals which lived in the sea. As they died, their bodies collected at the bottom of the ocean. Here they were covered by mud and sand. Over thousands of years, and layers of mud and sand become very thick. High temperature and pressure changed them into a thick black liquid called crude oil. When crude oil is pumped out of the ground, it is black, smelly liquid. It is a mixture of many chemicals which are very useful. They can be separated by a technique called fractional distillation. What is made from nylon? Here we have the examples, pictures. Nylon is a high performance plastic. It has great wear properties, impact properties, yes, and very durable, most often used for kitchen tools, automotive parts, medical tools, reels and gears, bearings, clothing and fabric, computer parts. All these three things are fossil fuels: coal, oil, and natural gas. Refining crude oil. Crude oil is a mixture of compounds called hydrocarbons. How is this mixture separated? Crude oil is refined by fractional distillation, which takes place in a tall tower called a fractionating tower. There, the oil is heated up. The compounds with low boiling points boil off first. They rise to the top of the tower. Compounds with higher boiling points are collected lower down. The different groups of compounds are called fractions. It is shown in this process. Fractional distillation of crude oil. Here we have the solid, very hot, over 400 degrees centigrade. Crude oil. Here we have the crude oil. So here we have the name of some fractions: gas, petrol, kerosene, diesel oil, lubricating oil, fuel oil, paraffin waxes, bitumen. Water fraction is used for gas is used as fuel, petrol is used as fuel for cars, and so on. What are fats? Fats are organic compounds that are made up of carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. They are a source of energy in foods. Fats belong to a group of substances called lipids, and they come in liquid and solid forms. All fats are the combination of saturated and unsaturated fatty acids. Fats serve as the storage substance of the body's extra calories. It fills the fat cells and helps insulate the body. Fats are also an important energy source. Products made from barrel of crude oil. Typical products made from a 42-gallon barrel to refined crude oil. Here we have 3% asphalt, 4% liquefied petroleum, 10% jet fuel, 18% other products, 23% diesel fuel and heating oil, 47% gasoline. Making margarine. Some of the fats and plant oils can be turned into valuable food, such as margarine. The oil for making margarine comes from the seeds of plants such as sunflowers. The sunflower seeds are crushed and squeezed to extract oil. The oil is refined by heating with sodium hydroxide. The impurities in the oil react to form a sort of soap. The purified oil is separated and then washed. Hydrogenation of the unsaturated acids in the oil takes place when the oil is heated with hydrogen under pressure over a nickel catalyst. The catalyst speeds up the reaction, which would otherwise be slow. So here, students, we have the whole picture of the process, that how the margarine make, the process of making margarine, oil seed from sunflower, stage number 1, stage number 2, then stage number 3, 4 and 5. Sunflower seeds, magnetized drum, vibrating sieve, dust toner, yes, then dehuler, flaker, cooker, pressure and sunflower oil. Detergents and soap. Detergents are chemicals which when dissolved in water can remove the dirt and grease from cloth, metal, ceramics and of course human skin. Soap is a detergent made from animal fats or plant oils. So here how soap is made. Here we have the stage number 1, fat or oil, hot water, heated under pressure. Stage number 2, separator, fatty acids, soap, glycerol for cosmetic, concentrated sodium hydroxide solution, perfumes, coloring and other additives, hot air, shaped and wrapped bars of soap. So in this way, soaps are made. Next, students, we have the salt exercise of lesson number 8. Question number 1, answer the following questions. Part A, physical change. When no new chemical substance is formed, a change is called a physical change. Physical changes are easy to reverse. Chemical change, when iron rusts or a candle burns, new chemical compounds are made. It may be impossible to reverse the process. These types of changes are called chemical changes or chemical reactions. Part B, in a chemical reaction, the following things happen. A new substance is made, energy is either given out or taken in. The change is almost impossible to reverse. Although the atoms of each element combine in different ways, the same atoms that were present at the start are there at the end of the reaction. Because of this, the total mass of the substances remains the same. Part C, there are some reactions which can be reversed. A simple example is the physical change when ice is heated to form water. The water can be changed back into ice. Another reversible change is the heating of blue copper sulfate. It decomposes to give white copper sulfate powder and water vapor. Part D, fertilizer. Fertilizer is a combination of elements that a plant needs in order to grow strong and healthy. A good fertilizer contains the elements needed to promote healthy growth in plants. It must also be cheap to produce and soluble in water. Part E, in industry, ammonium nitrate is made by reacting ammonia with nitric acid. Plastics, a plastic is a synthetic material which can easily be shaped. Plastics are usually tough and versatile. They are good electrical insulators. They can be spun into fibers to make cloths, carpets, or molded to make objects such as cups or chairs. Plastics are polymers. Polymers contain very large molecules that are made by adding together many small molecules called monomers. Some familiar polymers are polyethylene, polystyrene, and polyvinyl chloride. PVC, nylon, perspex, and trilene are the common names of some other important plastics. So here we have the uses of all these plastics. Crude oil. Crude oil is called a fossil fuel because it was made from fossils of animals that lived in the sea millions of years ago. Hundreds of millions of years ago, while ancient forests were starting to form coal on the land, other fossil fuels were being made under the sea. We use them now as oil and natural gas. Part H, petrol and kerosene. And part I, solid fuels, wood, coal, liquid fuels, petrol, kerosene, gaseous fuels, methane, butane. Part J, some of the fats and plant oils can be turned into valuable food such as margarine. The oil for making margarine comes from the seeds of plants such as sunflowers. The sunflower seeds are crushed and squeezed to extract oil. The oil is refined by heating with sodium hydroxide. The impurities in the oil react to form a sort of soap. The purified oil is separated and then washed. Hydrogenation of the unsaturated acids in the oil takes place when the oil is heated with hydrogen under pressure over a nickel catalyst. The catalyst speeds up the reaction, which would otherwise be slow. The fat is then heated and steam is blown over it to take away the unpleasant smell. Coloring, flavoring, and salt may be added. Vitamins are also added to make it healthier to eat. Part number J, detergents are chemicals which, when dissolved in water, can remove dirt and grease from cloth, metals, ceramics, and of course human skin. Soap is a detergent made from animal fats or plant oils. Part I, crude oil was made from the microscopic plants and animals which lived in the sea. As they died, their bodies collected at the bottom of the ocean. Here they were covered by mud and sand. Over thousands of years, the layers of mud and sand became very thick. High temperature of pressure changed them into thick black liquid called crude oil. Part M, gas, petrol, kerosene, diesel oil, lubricating oil, fuel oil, paraffin, waxes, bitumen. Question number 2, write whether the following chains are physical or chemical. First is chemical, second is physical, then chemical, physical, then physical, then chemical and chemical. Here we have the solved a worksheet. Question number 1, give a good definition of the physical chain. Give a good definition of a chemical chain. Physical chains are the chains affecting to form the form of a chemical substance, but not its chemical composition. Otherwise, chemical chain is any change that results in the formation of new chemical substances. So here, label the following as a chemical change or physical change: radiator boil over, chewing up burger, rusting iron, digesting a burger, moldy bread, baking bread, pounding and shaping horseshoes, cutting a board, setting fire to gasoline, folding paper, putting acid on paper, painting a wall, folding up a jacket, cutting the lawn, tearing up paper, running a gas engine, taking a motor apart, putting a motor together, writing on a paper, sewing a shirt, burning a candle, melting wax, melting ice, melting steel, boiling water, and freezing water. Write physical change or chemical change. Bread is baked is chemical change. Boiling water evaporates, physical change. A rock is smashed into pieces, physical change. An old nail gets rusty, chemical change. A frozen treat melts, yes, it is a physical change. An egg is cooked, it is a chemical change. This is all for today. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.